You know, one of the issues I think we have during this time, at least I can say to me, you may be all right, I can say to me, is that we seem to put so much stress and pressure on people.
Yeah.
Sometimes people we don't see, talk to or see all year to go out and spend money and go into debt and lie about how much they love us and they care about us, to buy gifts, fighting in lines, people fighting over TVs and stuff. Material stuff.
Man.
And that's not what it's all about.
No.
It's not all about who got the best gift or who got the most stuff.
Man.
It's not about that. It's about the fact that God loved us enough to give us a gift we can't afford.
All right.
And it's our taking the time out to take a moment to remember that. This Sunday I was going back and forth about Advent, and you know I was accosted by some people that said we could do this.
Right.
So I said, all right, we'll let y'all do this. So our Advent service this morning, I'm going to tip the family, just like nothing on her. By our children, but the Bible says a little child shall lead.
Amen.
We have learned that God promised he would raise up a great king for his people of Israel. God's people were waiting for his great king who would do only what was good and right and who would defeat Israel's enemies. God's king would rule not only over the people of Israel, but over the whole world. The greatest king of Israel ever had was named David. David's kingdom spread over a wide land and many people, but David did not rule over the whole world. The king that God promised was Jesus.
Yes.
Jesus was going to be a king like David, but Jesus was going to be far greater than David ever was. Jesus was born to be king over all people and all of creation. Let's bow our heads for prayer.
Yes. Yeah.